Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am going to do a oracle review of the secret language of the animal oracle cards. This is one of those oracle decks that I am so in love with, and the reason is because I don't know if I mentioned this in another video or not, but animals to me have been very, like, we had a connection since I was small. Animals are very important in my family. Especially on my father's side, there is a lot of connection with them, and knowing that when an animal appears to you, it's for a reason and it carries a message. So this deck really is one of those decks that I resonate with a lot, and it's by Chip Richards. It's in Blue Angel. It's a Blue Angel deck. I'm gonna open it. It comes in one of those hard boxes. The inside is brown. Of course, the Leo rising in me loves the lion here. It calls my soul. But besides that, it's a really good book. Let me see, the guidebook, it's 100 and without the, just where the meanings end. Okay, so it's 46 cards and it's 143 pages of meaning. After that, we do have some, he does include a page on endangered animal insights. And he lists a little bit of the species that are endangered. And he also lists resources for you. I believe it's here in the back, or it's so these are just some of the endangered species. I'm trying to see if he does have the resources, or am I just imagining it? No, I think he does have the resources. There we go. Choosing your cause. So he does have some websites here that you can go and visit their webpage and contribute to the cause of helping endangered species. So I really love that. And then we have a little bit of other oracle cards that he has made. I have this one, the Messenger Oracle, but that's only in my phone. I do not have it a hard copy, but I really love this oracle as well. Oh, these are other Blue Angel Publishings. They're not his. Okay, so hold on. Let me adjust my camera a little bit on my tripod, because I feel like I'm not getting enough of... Oh, okay. So let me put the cards aside so we can focus on the guidebook for a little bit. And then we will. So it's a Blue Angel Publishing deck. This deck came out in 2013. It's by Chip Richards. I love this dedication. To the living, loving pulse of Mother Earth and all of her sacred children. To Ashiana and Josh, thank you for your wonderful research and for sharing your own true nature so beautifully in the world. So we have the table of contents here. Then he starts with the beautiful introduction. I love to think of nature as an unlimited broadcasting station through which God speaks to us every hour if we only will tune in. And that is very true. I'm a firm believer that animals have a message for us. Today, this morning, I decided to go back to my running. I stopped for a while because I had a horrible car accident. I didn't crash. But the last time I went, my car was broken into and everything was stolen. I mean, my IDs, my wallet, everything. I had to replace my window. And it wasn't for the valuables. It was just a shock. And I got a little scared because I was like, oh my gosh, you know, is this a safe place or should I change places? So I took a break from that. And it's been like, I believe, a month that I stopped going. This happened on March the 9th, and now we're in April 16th, which today is my 7-year anniversary with my hubby. And I decided to go back, and I was walking when a a blue jay walked my path. And so I knew that carried personal message for me. So that's why I believe in that quote, that, you know, animals do carry messages and we just have to tune in. So he does, let's continue on with the guidebook. So there is using, he does introduce a little bit of using the cards, doing a one card reading, an elemental spread. And then he does have the medicine wheel spread as well, for those of you who do follow the medicine wheel. And then the totem vision. And it talks about that, how animals are messengers. And then we go into the card messages. So they are celebrated. They are separated by elements. So this is the water element, and he does have a little introduction on the water element. And then we have the cards that pertain to that element. So we have water, and this is all going to be the same. So we have a small representation of the card, the number, the title, and the key terms, as well as a little bit of history or facts about the animal or the element. And then we go into the message, and then he always ends it with the quote. So the quote is really good, again, for journaling. I'm a big fan of journaling. I know a lot of people don't like to journal, but I love it. So as you can see, I write on my guidebooks, I always do. So they're all the same. Then we have air, we also have fire. If I could, let's see. I think this is earth. Oh no, this is gonna be, yeah, earth. Air. Then we have fire. I just pressed fire. And then we have wood. And then we go back to what I had said, that he does some insights on endangered animals, and then he lists the costs. So I'm gonna go ahead to the cards, and so you can have a look at them. I believe this artwork is by Jimmy Manton. I believe, let me have a look. I'm not sure. I want to say it was Jimmy Manton, but yep, Jimmy Manton. So he's, I love his artwork. So here we have polar bear. As you're gonna see, these they have different color borders because they match the element. So this is polar bear. Beautiful artwork. As you can see, it does have a small border. It does have the number up on top. It has done the animal's name or the element, and then some key terms. So this would be polar bear. Crow is another one of my spirit animals. I love crow. Dolphins. Wild horse. Dragonfly. Just the colors on this deck is stunning to me. His artwork is, his writing also, Chip Richards' writing, and how he connects the messages to each animal. It's amazing. I love it. I haven't worked with any other deck, Eagle, that resonates so much with my soul and the way I see the animal's message. And there's some animals in here that I would have never, that I've never seen where I live, at least, and that I wasn't aware of, but they're really good. Blue whale, albatross. Black cockatoo, fire, golden spider, Earth, shark, snow leopard. I am going to pull a card at the end of the reading. I'm also going to use my own personal oracle deck that I created last year, I believe. It's nothing major. I mean, it was just a way for me to develop a sacred language with spirit. But some of the images do have family pictures in them. So, do have family members in those pictures. So, if a family member comes out, I love this lion card. I will not show the image because I do not have their authorization to show their faces in my channel. But I will pull a card. Giant panda, red squirrel, fairy wren, tree frog. I will read from the guidebook so you get an idea of how the guidebook is written and how, just get a feel for the guidebook. Orange blossom jellyfish, because I love that. Sometimes I could resonate with the images of a deck, but if the writing, because I'm a, as you guys, if you guys don't know, I love reading, and the reading has to resonate with me. Because if it's, let's say, I have several decks where I could do a video on that, where I like the images and everything, but the way the guidebook is written, it's like there's a lot of missing information that I wish the author would have incorporated. And usually those decks, I give them away, or I try to work with them for a while, but then if I just can't for whatever reason and it bothers me, then I will not do that. I will. So this is the backing. It's not reversible. And I have a feeling it was not meant to be reversible. Again, the Leo rising in me loves this. I love the lion. So let's see. Let's see. What is our message for today? Okay, we got our card. Okay, we have our card. And let's see, let's see. Polar bear number 3 to the Empress. Polar bear, solitude, friendship, strength, and resilience. So let me read off the guidebook, number 3. So it's water element, okay? Oh, shoot. Okay, let's put this here so you're able to see it. I'm going to leave this like this in case if you want to read a little bit of facts and history about the polar bears. You can pause it, take a picture of it, and read it. I will go straight to the message. Amidst the pressures and extremes of daily life, sometimes we can lose sight of where we are going. Polar bear brings you the gift of inner strength and the ability to move with great power and intelligence beyond what may have limited you in the past, into the full experience of that which calls you now. Step forward with confidence and determination. Polar bear brings the gift of resilience, driven by a purity of spirit that focuses not on the obstacles but on the higher vision of the ultimate outcome you are seeking. Polar bear says, speak your truth and find constructive ways to express the emotions that arise within you. His message is to hold strong to what you know while remaining flexible and open to what emerges. Find the balance between the extremes by walking your journey long enough to let that which no longer serves you fall away and melt back into the sea. Sometimes your growth calls for solitude and quiet introspection. Sometimes your heart yearns to come together into communion with another. Sometimes you must conserve your energy, and sometimes you must leap with full, unbridled expression into the pursuit of your dreams. Whatever you find yourself, wherever you find yourself presently, polar bear comes as an ally. guiding you to the heart center on your own inner strength. Take time to walk with Polar Bear. Measure your approach and gather your energy close. When the moment comes to move forward, to move toward your goal, you will do so with absolute clarity and power. I am anchored in my center and aligned with my purpose. When I am still, I am quiet within. When I move with great power. I am purity in motion, endurance in the night. I am inner strength and wisdom in full expression of my light. So that is the message. And what I got out of it is we know, and we have to, we know, we will know when is the right time to take that leap, or when is the, or if we need to, or if we need solitude. So whatever your intuition is telling you, that's what you need to do. You need to take a step back and kind of, you know, regroup or rethink certain things, then that is okay. If you feel like now is the time to come into union with somebody else, then that is what you are supposed to do. I can't speak my words, right? Speak your truth. So that's another one. And don't lose sight of where you're going. Always keep your sight on the end goal. So I'm gonna pull some cards from my oracle. I have it wrapped in this little, like, let's see. So it's just like that. It's not reversible. Let's see. Okay, see, that has family members, so let me just... Action. And another animal. We have the tiger. To me, tigers represent high priestess energy. I always have dreams of tiger. Tigers, they're always very present in my dreams. I'm gonna pull it up close. So this is a moment to take action. Again, I wanted to represent here the tiger, to be still, because tigers, they're very discerning. They're very quiet, and then they take that action too, after what they want. So this is kind of repeating the same thing the polar bear did. They're telling you that whatever you feel, if you feel like you need to step back, or if you feel like you need to take action, this will be the time to take action. And the lunar here is also telling me that this is, some of you, this will be rising because of the new moon that happened yesterday. For some of you, it's happening today, depending where you are. And I did say in that video that I did yesterday was that the new moon in Aries, it's gonna provide us with not a huge risk, but we're gonna have to take a leap in some way, shape, or form. And we have to decide if we're ready to take action. It's gonna be a energy that's gonna push us into action. Of course, we do not wanna be reckless, but we do have to take action because the goal that we wanna accomplish is within reach. But it's going to require you to have faith and trust yourself and make that jump. Thank you very much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Again, this was the Secret Language of the Animals Oracle Cards. I'll see you next time. Bye.